Laryngeal cancer has multiple forms of treatment available. Primarily, if it's caught early, surgical treatment is a very good option and has very high success rates. There are multiple ways for surgical treatment of early laryngeal cancers, one of which is CO2 laser. Patients can be subjected to what's called a laser laryngectomy. A patient is put to sleep, a rigid laryngoscope is placed through the patient's oral cavity, and with that patient asleep, a laser can be used to essentially remove the tumor. And again, this is for early stage tumors. There are other sort of more traditional ways to do that, also through the mouth. We can use microlaryngeal instruments to essentially cut the tumor out, to remove the tumor, and a cup of normal tissue around the tumor to make sure all this microscopic disease is removed. The latest, greatest thing in the technological world is the use of transoral robotic surgery. So a lot of the sort of tertiary academic medical centers, they're using these transoral robots to precisely remove the tumors. It gives you direct, fantastic visualization of the tumor area and what's normal and what's not normal. Some patients choose not to undergo surgery, and radiation is another modality that can be explored. Primary radiation treatment for early laryngeal cancer also has a very high success rate. In fact, it rivals surgery. So I will often counsel patients that come in with early laryngeal cancer about both modalities, surgery versus radiation. Radiation does have some advantages of not needing a general anesthetic, not needing to undergo a surgical type of procedure, but it also has disadvantages in sometimes patients develop long-term sequelae such as sore throat, dry mouth, difficulty swallowing later on in life. Now, for more advanced forms of cancer, whether it be in the larynx or one of the structures around the larynx, sometimes it's a combination type of treatment. Both surgery and radiation, plus or minus chemotherapy, will be offered to get the best chances of local control.